Here is why all the planets orbit in the same direction. At school, we're taught that all the planets in the solar system orbit the sun in a plane as if they were on a vast and invisible cloth that supports them all. But do the planets orbit around the sun in the same plane? Why do they all orbit in the same direction? And could a planet orbit in the opposite direction to all the others? We will answer all those questions in this video, so stay with us to find out. The ecliptic. When we see the planets from Earth, they're always within an ecliptic zone. This is an imaginary line that the sun and the planets follow in the sky. When the first astronomers in history began to observe the movements of the planets, they realized that they always followed a well-defined path through the ecliptic, and that no known planet was outside this region. However, with the advancements of astronomical observation and the invention of astronomical telescopes and observatories, astronomers realized that, although all the planets were always in the same region of the sky, they were sometimes on different planes. The reason is that by measuring the distances at which the planets are and the size of their orbits, some astronomers such as Johannes Kepler realized at the beginning of the 17th century that the planets had slightly inclined orbits. Also, the planets do not orbit the sun in a circle, but rather in an ellipse. This is how Kepler formulated Kepler's three laws, describing the relationship between elliptical orbit shape and the planet's speed as they traverse them. These laws established a framework for predicting and understanding the motion of celestial bodies and are an essential component of celestial mechanics. For its part, the elliptical not only defines the general shape of the planetary orbits, but also influences the variations in the orbital velocity of the planets. When a planet is closer to the sun, perihelion, it experiences a more significant acceleration due to the greater gravitational influence. On the other hand, when it is further away, aphelion, it experiences a deceleration due to the lower gravitational influence. This results in a non-linear relationship between the time a planet takes to complete its orbit and its distance from the sun. This means that although the planets revolve around the sun at different speeds, and although we are taught as children that all the planets orbit the sun in the same plane, the reality is that they do not. Do all the planets really orbit the sun in the same plane and in the same direction? Empirical observation has convincingly shown that the planets of the solar system follow a relatively common path around the sun. Although there are minor variations in the inclinations and eccentricities of their orbits, generally speaking, all planets orbit in a nearly aligned plane and counterclockwise direction as seen from the sun's north pole. The supposed alignment is relative to the observer, since if we look at each planet separately, we see that each planet has a different orbital inclination than all the others. But if so, why at school and in science books is the solar system always presented to us as if all the planets orbited in the same plane? The reason for this is that these orbital inclinations on the planets are very small compared to the orbit they have. For example, when Kepler discovered that the planets had elliptical orbits and not circular ones, many thought that the year's seasons were because global temperatures increased when the Earth was closer to the Sun, and the temperatures began to drop when the Earth was farther. Although the distance from the Earth to the Sun during aphelion, when it is farthest from the Sun, and perihelion, when it is closest to the Sun, can vary by several million kilometers, today we know that the seasons do not depend on that distance, but rather the hemisphere of the Earth that is most illuminated by the Sun. In other words, although the Earth and all the planets have elliptical orbits, they appear to have circular orbits at first glance, since the ellipse they describe has a very slight curve. The same goes for orbital inclinations. Although all the planets have different inclinations and each orbits the Sun in its orbital plane, these inclinations are so small compared to their orbits that it appears that they all orbit in the same plane. Why do the planets have these orbits? The planetary system we call home originated from a giant cloud of gas and dust that began to collapse under its gravity about 4.6 billion years ago. As this cloud contracted, it began to spin faster due to the conservation of angular momentum. This rotational motion formed a flattened protoplanetary disk, with the Sun at the center and surrounding materials in orbit around it. The gravitational interaction between the materials and the protoplanetary disk was the primary catalyst for forming the planets. As tiny particles of dust and gas clumped into developing protoplanets, they began to orbit the Sun to balance the gravitational pull that pulled them inward and the inertia that pulled them out. This process, known as accretion, only occurred uniformly in some regions of the protoplanetary disk. The uneven distribution of matter in the disk and the gravitational interactions between the growing protoplanets caused local perturbations in the orbits of these bodies. These perturbations gave rise to slight variations in the inclinations and eccentricities of the planetary orbits, which explains the observed differences in orbital alignment. Also, the formation of giant planets like Jupiter and Saturn significantly impacted the system's structure. The intense gravity of these gas giants disturbed the orbits of the more minor planets, influencing their orbital positions and speeds. This massive gravitational interaction was key in shaping the planetary orbits and determining their general arrangement. Over millions of years, gravitational interactions and mutual influences led to a state of global equilibrium that we observe today. Despite minor variations, the planetary orbits are consistent with how they formed, so they all orbit in the same direction that the Sun rotates on itself. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Do comets and asteroids also orbit in the same direction and the same plane as the planets? While the uniformity of planetary orbits in the solar system is well established, the history of comets and asteroids presents a more complex plot regarding orbital alignment. Although for the most part they follow the general rules of planetary motion, these objects have also revealed an orbital diversity that enriches our understanding of the cosmos and the processes that have shaped our planetary system. Comets and asteroids are remnants of the formation of the solar system, material that did not consolidate into planets or moons. Mostly, they also orbit the Sun in an elliptical path, similar to that of the planets. But this is where the similarities start to blur. Regarding orbital alignment, most asteroids share a similar plane and direction of motion as the planets. However, there are some notable exceptions. The so-called Trojan asteroids, found at specific points in Jupiter's orbit, have elliptical paths that vary in inclination and direction. Comets, on the other hand, present a greater diversity in their orbits. Long-period comets, like the famous Halley's Comet, come from the region of the Kuiper Belt and the Oort Cloud, areas well beyond Neptune's orbit. These comets can have highly eccentric and inclined orbits compared to the planet's orbital plane. As they get closer to the Sun, they can significantly change their trajectory due to the gravitational influence and the sublimation forces they experience when they heat up. However, unlike planets, comets and asteroids can orbit in the opposite direction to the planets. Asteroids that orbit the Sun in the opposite direction are known as retrograde asteroids. In our solar system, several examples of this type of body, which orbit in the opposite direction to the planets, defy all logic. These objects that orbit in the opposite direction to the body they orbit are usually captured by another massive body that puts them in a new orbit. For example, Jupiter, the most massive body in the solar system, has such a strong gravitational pull that throughout its history has captured many asteroids that orbit the planet in the opposite direction. All bodies that orbit in the opposite direction to the rotation of the main body are known as retrograde objects. Something similar happens in Neptune with its satellite Triton. This is the gas giant's largest moon. Triton orbits in the opposite direction to the rotation of the planet, and it is thought that this occurs because millions of years ago, Triton could have been an icy body like Pluto that passed too close to Neptune and was captured by its gravity, thus becoming a satellite but with a retrograde orbit. Similarly, just as planets can capture some bodies and place in retrograde orbits, these gravitational forces can sometimes move asteroids and comets into retrograde orbits around the Sun. As we can see, when it comes to small bodies such as asteroids, comets, or moons, other larger bodies may manage to pull them in retrograde orbits. But can the same thing happen with a planet? Could a planet orbit in a different direction from all the others? The answer is yes. It could be that a planet had a retrograde orbit concerning the Sun. But for this to happen, two scenarios would have to occur. The first is that a small planet like Mars would cross the path of other massive planets like Jupiter, and these, having a greater gravitational force, eventually take it out of its orbit, and after many movements over millions of years, manage to make the small planet acquire a new orbit, but in the opposite direction to the rotation of the Sun. The second option is a bit simpler. In this case, the planet in question would have to come from another star. That's right, if an exoplanet, for example, ejected from a nearby star suddenly entered our solar system and ended up being captured by the Sun's gravity, depending on the direction and angle at which it entered our solar system, it could acquire a retrograde orbit. Like the satellites that Jupiter captures, the Sun could capture an exoplanet and keep it in a stable orbit along with all the other planets, even if it had a retrograde orbit. Is there a planet with that feature? The answer again is yes. That planet is called WASP-17b. This exoplanet, located about 1,000 light-years away in the constellation Scorpius, defines expectations by orbiting its star in the opposite direction to the direction the star rotates on its axis. Its retrograde trajectory suggests that this planet may have experienced a turbulent past due to gravitational interactions with other nearby planets or external influences. WASP-17b's retrograde orbit offers us a unique insight into orbital diversity in planetary systems outside of our own. Their study provides valuable clues about the information and evolution processes that may have shaped this curious exoplanet. In a universe of surprises, WASP-17b is a captivating example of the wide variety of worlds waiting to be discovered and understood beyond our planetary borders. Now that we know that if there can be asteroids, comets, moons, and planets that rotate in the opposite direction to their star, the next obvious question is, could there be stars that rotate in the opposite direction to the rotation of the galaxy? If you want us to make a video answering this question, let us know in the comments.